ॐ ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकाय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशकौपातरुभ्यश्च कृपसिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभुनित्यानन्द श्रीअद्वैतगदाधर श्रीवासदिगौरभक्तवृन्द। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। All right, we're reading Krishna book and we're reading about Lord Krishna going to visit two devotees named Shrutadeva and Bahulasva. This is chapter 86 in the Krishna book.
我们今天继续来阅读 Krishna 至尊人格所说。我们读的是第五章，Krishna 造访 Shrutadeva 和 Bahulasva。
So Lord Krishna had come from Dwarka along with all of his associates to visit these two persons who resided quite a distance away from Dwarka.
Krishna 从 Dwarka 带了他的随从，他们来到这里。这个地方和 Dwarka 有一段距离。
So Lord Krishna performed a miracle when he went there. He went to visit both of them, both the king, Bahulashva, and the Brahmana, Shrutadev. He went to visit both of them simultaneously.
如 Krishna 在这里呢，就展示了一个奇迹。他同时造访了国王巴胡拉什瓦以及婆罗门舒塔德。
And not only did Lord Krishna go to visit both these people simultaneously, but all the people who were accompanying him, all of the great sages, they also went to visit both people simultaneously.
并经主 Krishna 同时的访问了这两个人，和陪同他前来的这些圣人们，也同一时刻造访了所有这两个人的家中。
So we're hearing, first of all, how Lord Krishna was received in the palace of King Bahulashva, and how the king was very honored and respectful to have Lord Krishna come there and give him a wonderful reception.
首先呢，就描述了在巴胡拉什瓦这宫殿里发生的事情。国王呢感到无比的荣幸，能有主 Krishna 来到他这里，所以他就很好的迎接了他。
So King Bahulashva took the lotus feet of Lord Krishna on his lap and began to massage his lotus feet, and he began to speak very sweet words to him.
国王巴胡拉什瓦就把主 Krishna 莲花足放在自己的膝上，就按摩了，这个 Krishna 莲花足。
And he told Lord Krishna, "My dear Lord, you are the super soul of all living entities and the witness within the heart."
巴胡拉什瓦王说道：“亲爱的主。”你是众生的 Paramatma 超灵，身为世人心中的见证。
So, because you're the witness within the heart, you know about everyone's activities.
因为你是世人心中的见证，所以你知悉人的活动。
King Bahulasva said, "It's our duty to always think of your lotus feet, that we can always, that by thinking of your lotus feet, we can remain in a secure position."
巴胡拉什瓦王继续说道：“因此，我们有义务经常思念你的莲花组。” 当我们思念你的莲花族的时候，我们的地位就是安全的。
And we won't fall away from your eternal service.
我们就不会远离你的永恒服务。
So by constantly remembering your lotus feet, this is the reason why you've kindly visited my place personally. Because I'm always thinking of your lotus feet. That's the reason why you've personally come to see me.
正是因为我不断的思念你莲花族，结果你便仁慈的亲自来探访我。
You have come to favor me with your causeless mercy.
你以无缘的恩慈来赐福于我。
And we have heard that by your various statements, we know that you confirm that your pure devotees are very dear to you, more dear to you than even Lord Balaram or the Goddess of Fortune.
我们曾听闻你以各项声明证实你的纯粹奉献者比主 Balaram 或蓄女神对你而言更为的真爱。
Your devotees, your pure devotees are more dear to you than your own first son, Lord Brahma.
你的纯粹奉献者比你的第一个儿子 Brahma 更为亲密。
And I'm sure you've come to visit my place just to prove these words of yours.
我肯定你来此探访我，全为证实你的这些话语。
And King Bahulasva said, I'm not able to understand how people could be godless and how people could be demonic. Even after knowing about your mercy and your love for your devotees, it's inconceivable to me how some people could be demonic and godless.
Bahulasva 继续说道，我不能想象人们如何在知悉了你的无缘恩慈与深情后，还持有无神论和邪恶的意念。
Because you always. These people should know, they somehow don't appreciate the mercy and affection which you show for your pure devotees.
这些人无论如何不能欣赏你对你纯粹奉献者的无缘恩慈与深情。
Your pure devotees are always engaged in your lotus feet, and they're always in Krishna consciousness, remembering your lotus feet.
你的纯粹奉献者总是处于 Krishna 知觉当中，他们无法忘怀你的莲花足。
So it's inconceivable to me how people could be demonic and can forget about your lotus feet.
所以我不能想象人们怎么还能持有无神论和邪恶的观点，忘记了莲花族。
So king, the king says to Lord Krishna, "I know that you are very kind and liberal. And when a person leaves everything just to become your devotee, you sometimes may give yourself for that devotee in exchange for his service. You may give yourself to him. You've taken your birth in the Yadu dynasty just to fulfill your mission to reclaim the conditioned souls who are rotting in the material world.
你在鸭渡王朝出生，来拯救这些，在去实现你拯救受天眷限制灵魂的使命。这些受限灵魂们在物质世界，在物质世界，在那里腐烂着。
Your appearance is famous all over the world.
现在您的显现已经闻名遐迩。You're
the ocean of mercy, love, and affection.
您是爱、仁慈和深情的海洋。And
your transcendental form is always full of bliss and knowledge and eternity.
你的超然形体充满快乐、知识与永恒。And
you attract everyone's heart by your beautiful form as Shyamasundara Krishna.
你以美丽形体 Shyamasundara Krishna 捕获了每个人的心灵。Your
knowledge is unlimited.
你的知识无穷无尽。
And you sent your incarnation, Narayan, to teach us how to do devotional service.
你派遣你的化身，Narayana，前来教导世人如何执行奉爱服务。He
is doing severe austerities and penances at Badrikashram.
他在巴珍纳特阿什姆一地从事严格的苦修以及忏悔。So
please accept my humble obeisances at your lotus feet.
因此请你仁慈地接受我在你的莲花足下顶拜。
The king says to Lord Krishna, I beg to request you and your companions, who are all the great sages and brahmanas, to remain at my place, at least for a few days.
国王说，我请求你与同伴那些伟大的圣者与婆罗门们，在我家最少留几天。
And in this way, this family of the famous King Nimi can be purified by the dust of your lotus feet.
这样，尼米王这个著名的家庭就能被你莲花祖所净化。So
Lord Krishna could not refuse the request of his devotee, so he stayed there for a few days with all the sages.
主Krishna无法拒绝他奉献者的请求，便与圣者在那里逗留数天。In
this way, Lord Krishna sanctified the city of Mithila and all the citizens.
就这样，主Krishna净化了米提拉城和那里的所有居民们。
So at the same time this was going on, Lord Krishna was also visiting the Brahmana Shrutadev.
与此同时，主 Krishna 也造访了 Shrutadev 家。
And Lord Krishna and all of his associates had gone to the home, and Shrutadev was, he was overjoyed. He was so happy to see Lord Krishna come to his home.
Lord Krishna 和他的同游来到这位婆罗门的家中，这位婆罗门便沉醉于超然的快乐之中。
So first of all, Shrutadev offered a nice sitting place for everyone. And then he began to dance. And he was waving around his chadar.
这位婆罗门招待客人，给所有客人提供了很好的座位之后，便跳起舞来，把他的披肩，在空中挥舞。
So Shrutadev was very poor. He wasn't rich at all. So he could only offer some mattresses and wooden planks and straw carpets for the guests to sit on.
Shrutadev 并不是很富有，他很贫穷，他只能送上坐垫、木板和草席给他们的客人。
And so Lord Krishna and the great sages, they accepted whatever things he offered to them.
主 Krishna 和圣哲们接受了这位婆罗门给他们提供的这些。
They knew that the Brahmana was offering everything according to the best of his ability.
他们深知这位婆罗门呢已经是尽自己所能来招待他们。
So Shrutadev spoke very nice words about everyone, welcoming them to his home.
Shrutadev 婆罗门呢开始赞美主 Krishna 和圣者们，欢迎他们来到他家中。
And then Lord Shrutadev and his wife, they washed the feet.Of each of the guests who had come there to his home.
Shrutadev 还和妻子们逐一的为来到家中的客人们洗他们的足。
And then he took the water and he sprinkled it over the heads of his family members.
然后他把涤足之水洒在家人的头上。
So the Brahmana was very poor, but he was also very fortunate.
婆罗门虽然贫寒，但却无比的幸运。
And he was welcoming Lord Krishna and all of his associates, and welcoming him, he was so happy that he forgot all about himself.
这样招待 Krishna 和众人的时候，在超然的快乐之中，简直忘记了自己。
And then he brought fruits and incense and scented water.
接待过他们之后，他用水果、香和香水来供奉他们。
And he brought also tulsi leaves and kusha straw and lotus flowers.
他还拿来 tulsi 叶子、kusha 草和莲花。
So he was giving them things which were not very expensive. They were not costly things.
这些呢，并不是珍贵的物品，随手可得。
They were easily available in the market.
在市场上轻易的就能买到。
But because the Brahmana was offering them to Lord Krishna with so much love, Lord Krishna and his devotees, they accepted everything they offered.
但因为婆罗门是以爱来奉献供奉，主 Krishna 和他的同友们也高兴地接纳了。
And the Brahmana's wife, she was cooking for them. So she cooked rice and dal. And Lord Krishna and his followers, they're very pleased to accept the simple meal which they cook for them.
婆罗门妻子呢，为客人们烹煮了大米饭和豆汤。
Then Lord Krishna knew that whatever was offered to him, it was being offered with pure love.
主 Krishna 知道，无论婆罗门和妻子供奉的是什么，都是怀着爱心所供奉的。So
when Lord Krishna and all of his associates, the great brahmanas, when they were all fed, then Shruta Deva was thinking how to address the Lord, what to say to the Lord.
当客人们尽善完毕，舒适地坐着，Shruta Deva便开始考虑该如何开口说话。
So Shruta Deva was thinking that I've fallen into the dark well of household life. I am the most unfortunate person.
Shruta Deva Brahman 想着，我堕进了深暗的居士生活苦境中，是最为不幸的人。
How has it become possible that Lord Krishna, the personality of Godhead, and all of his associates, the great sages, have all come to my house?
为什么至尊人歌手神主 Krishna 和他的圣哲同游们竟然来到了我的家中呢？
Wherever they go, their presence makes a place of pilgrimage.
无论他们去哪里，都使那个地方 变成了朝圣之地。
And somehow they've decided to come to my home, to my simple house.
无论如何，他们竟然来到了我这个陋室，简单的陋室。
So while the Shruta Deva was thinking like this, that the guests, they finished their meal and they sat back very comfortable, satisfied.
他这样想着想着，客人们已经尽善完毕，舒适地坐在那里。So
then Shruta Dev got his wife and his children and the other relatives, they all appeared there to come to give service to the different guests who were there at his house.
婆罗门舒特德便和妻儿和亲人们替这些客人做服务。So
while the Brahmana was touching the lotus feet of Lord Krishna, he began to speak to offer prayers.
婆罗门一边触碰着主 Krishna 莲花足，他一边开始讲话。And
he said to Lord Krishna, he said, "My dear Lord, you are the supreme person, Purushottam, transcendentally situated beyond the material nature."
婆罗门说道，亲爱的主，你是至尊歌手神，Purushottam，你超然于物质创造之上。The
activities of this material world and the conditioned souls have nothing to do with you.
此间物质世界和受条件灵魂的活动和你没有丝毫的关系。Not
only today, not only today you have given me your audience, but you are associating with everyone since the beginning of creation as the Paramatma.
你并非在今天才出现在我面前，而是在创造之初已经以超灵的身份与一切有关联。
So the Shruta Devi is a Brahmana, so what he said was very, very important, very instructive.
婆罗门这番话十分的有教育意义，非常重要。
So we should understand that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and in his Paramatma feature, he enters the creation of the material world as Mahavishnu, Garbhadakshayi Vishnu, Shiradakshayi Vishnu. And in a very friendly way, he sits in the hearts of all the conditioned souls.
至尊阁守神呢，以超灵的形象进入这个物质的创造，成为 Mahavishnu， 运蛋之羊 Vishnu 以及牛奶之羊 Vishnu， 他友善的坐在所有生物心中。
So every living entity has Krishna with him from the very beginning.
每一个生物一开始便有主陪伴在他心中。
But because his mistake, because his consciousness is wrong, because of his wrong consciousness, the living entity cannot understand this.
但是生物体因为错误的知觉使他不能明白这些。
But when his consciousness is changed to Krishna consciousness, then he can understand.
如果他的知觉变成 Krishna 知觉，便能够明白。
Then he can understand how Krishna is trying to help all the conditioned souls to get out of the material world.
他能够明白Krishna 如何尝试着帮助受条件限制的灵魂从物质世界当中解放出来。
So Shruta Dev, the Brahmana says to Lord Krishna, you have entered this material world as if sleeping.
婆罗门 Shruta Dev 继续说，你像在睡眠的状态下进入这个物质世界。
When a conditioned soul sleeps, then he will create false and temporary worlds in his mind.
受条件限制的灵魂在睡梦中，在心意里创造了虚假、短暂的世界。
In this way, he is busy in many illusory activities.
他忙于许多虚幻的活动。
Sometimes he becomes a king.
啊，有时候成为国王。
Sometimes he becomes a murderer.
他有时候成为了谋杀犯。
And sometimes he's going to an unknown city.
有时候他去了不知名的城市。
These are all just temporary affairs of the material world.
这些都是物质世界的短暂事物。
So in the same way, Lord Krishna sometimes is in a sleeping condition and he enters this material world.
同样的，主 Krishna 有的时候以睡眠状态进入这个物质世界。
He enters the material world and he creates a temporary world just for the enjoyment of the conditioned souls.
他进入这个物质世界，创造这个展示，只是为了这些受条件限制灵魂的享受。
Because the conditioned souls, they want to imitate Krishna's position. They want to be the supreme enjoyer. They want to think they are the supreme enjoyer.
受条件限制的灵魂希望模仿至尊主，当至尊的享受者。
Of course, the conditioned soul's enjoyment in this material world is temporary.
当然，受条件限制灵魂的享受是短暂的。
And it's all illusion, but the conditioned soul still thinks he's enjoying.
尽管这些都是虚假的，但受限制的灵魂仍然认为自己还在享受。
So in the same way, Lord Krishna enters this temporary material world just to help the conditioned souls.
Lord Krishna 进入这个物质世界只是为了帮助受条件限制的灵魂。
From the beginning, when we first enter into the material world, Lord Krishna is with us, helping us.
从我们一开始进入这个物质世界，主 Krishna 就在和我们在一起，帮助我们。
And when the conditioned soul comes in contact with a pure devotee and takes to devotional service, so that is the special mercy of Krishna.
当受条件限制的灵魂与一位纯粹的奉献者接触，从事奉爱服务，这是 Krishna 的仁慈。
And from the pure devotee association, then we learn about hearing and chanting the glories of Krishna.
由于与纯粹的奉献者连接触，我们学习了聆听和唱诵 Krishna 的荣耀。
And we learn to worship your eternal form in the temple.
我们学习如何在庙中崇拜你的永恒形体。
And we offer prayers to you, and we offer prayers to you and engage in understanding all your transcendental qualities.
我们向你祷告，并且明白你的超然地位。
And in this way, we get free from the contamination of material existence.
这样便逐渐从物质存在的污染中解放出来。
So gradually, the heart becomes clean of all the material dust.
逐渐的，心灵的物质污垢得以洁净。
And when our heart is clean, then we can actually see you there.
当我们心灵变得干净之后，便可以在心中看见你。
Although you're constantly with us, you're constantly with us conditioned souls. Only when we become purified by devotional service do you become visible to us.
你虽然常与受条件限制灵魂在一起，只有当他受奉爱服务净化时，你才能对他启示。
For people who are bewildered with material desires, they may follow the Vedic injunctions or perform different rituals. But if they don't take to devotional service, they cannot get the real goal of life.
有物质愿望的人们会遵循韦达训谕从事一些仪式性活动，但如果不进行奉爱服，他们不能实现生命的目标。
And if they don't take to devotional service, they become attracted to the temporary happiness of the material world and the bodily conception of life.
他们如果不做奉爱夫，便会受物质世界的短暂快乐所吸引，沉浸在躯体化的生命概念。
So we know you never reveal yourself to such people. You always remain far away from them.
我们知道，你便不会把自己揭示给这样的人，反而远远地离开他们。
But if somebody engages in your devotional service, and if he chants your holy name, you're very easily understood as their eternal constant companion.
但那些从事对你的奉爱服务，不断唱诵你圣名，而是这样的人便能很容易明白你是永恒的伴侣。
So the Brahmana continued to speak to Lord Krishna, and he said to him that, I know you're sitting in the heart of a devotee, and you give him direction so that he can very quickly go back home, back to Godhead.
婆罗门继续对主说道，你触及于奉献者心中，给他指示，使他很快地重返家园，回归守神。
So because you give instructions to them, you reveal your existence within the heart of the devotee.
你直接地指导他们，并且你存在在奉献者的心中。
Only a devotee can appreciate your existence in the heart.
只有奉献者才能欣赏到你存在于心中。
But somebody who is in the bodily conception of life is just engaged in sense gratification. They cannot understand.
但是，处于生命躯体化概念的人们却忙于感官满足。
So you're always covered by the yoga maya. These people can never realize you.
所以你经常被你的 yoga maya 所遮蔽，这些人不能觉悟到你。
For a non-devotee, for someone who's not a devotee, they can only appreciate you as death.
对奉献者来说，他们只能认识你是死亡。
But for a devotee, we know you're sitting in the heart.
但对于奉献者们，他们知道你就居于心中。
So Shrutadev gives an example. He said, the difference is like a cat carrying its kitten in its mouth and the same cat carrying a rat in its mouth.
Shrutadev 就打了个比喻，就好像猫儿衔着小猫和叼着老鼠的去分别。
In the mouth of the cat, the rat knows death is very near. But the kitten in the mouth of the cat, it feels the affection of its mother.
老鼠在猫儿口中感到死亡将近，但小猫则能感到母爱。
So in the same way, you are present to everyone, but the non-devotee feel you as cruel death, but the devotee feels you as the supreme instructor and philosopher.
同样道理，你存在于每个人的心中，但非奉献者感到你是无情的死神，而奉献者则视你为至尊的指导者和哲学家。
The atheist understands the presence of God as death.
无神论者，他们把神视为死亡。
But the devotee understands God within the heart, and they take instruction from him.
奉献者则明白神存在于心中，接受神的指导。
So the devotee is unaffected by the material world.
奉献者便不受物质世界的污染。
So Shrutadev, the Brahmana, continues to glorify Lord Krishna. He said, you are the supreme controller and the superintendent of the material nature.
婆罗门 Shrutadev 继续荣耀主说，你是物质自然活动的至尊主宰兼监督。
And the atheistic class of men, they only see the activities of the material nature. They cannot see you behind everything.
无神论者只能观察物质自然的活动，却不知道你是在万事万物背后的那个人。
But a devotee can see, he can immediately see your hand behind everything in the material nature.
一个奉献者能立刻看到你在主持着物质自然的每一项活动。
The curtain of yoga maya cannot cover the eyes of the devotee.
Yoga maya 的剧目不能遮掩你奉献者的目光。
But it can easily cover the eyes of people who are not devotees.
但却能轻易地蒙蔽非奉献者。
The non-devotee is not able to see you face to face.
非奉献者不能面对面看见你。
Just like if a person's eyes are blocked by the covering of a cloud, they cannot see the sun.
就如人的双眼被云彩所遮盖，无法看见太阳。
So people who are flying above the cloud, they can see the sun.
飞跃在云端之上的人们可以看见太阳。
So the Brahmana said to Lord Krishna, I offer my obeisances unto you, my dear Lord.
Brahmana Shrutadev 说，亲爱的主，我向你顶拜。
I am your eternal servant.
我是你的永恒仆人。
So please order me, what can I do for you?
请命令我，我能为你做些什么呢？
So the conditioned soul feels the pain of material contamination.
受条件限制的灵魂无时不感到物质污染的痛苦。
He feels the three different kinds of miseries of the material world.
他体验到物质世界的三重苦。
So long as you're not visible to him, the conditioned soul will feel this misery.
受条件限制的灵魂一天看不见你就会感受体验到物质的三重苦。
And as soon as you are visible by our Krishna consciousness, when we're Krishna conscious, then you become visible to us and all the miseries of material existence are finished.
一旦我们发展了 Krishna 之觉，便能看到你，所有物质存在的痛苦便顿然地消失了。
So Krishna is very much affectionate, he's very much attached to his devotees.
Krishna 非常钟爱和依附他的奉献者。
And when he heard Shrutadev's prayers of pure devotion, he was very pleased.
当他听到 Shrutadev 的纯粹的、满怀爱心的祷文后，非常欣喜。
And he caught hold of the hand of Shrutadev And he said to him, my dear Brahmana, all these great sages and Brahmanas and saintly persons have been very kind to you by personally coming here to see you.
比如说，亲爱的 Shuta Dev， 这些伟大的圣人，这些伟大的圣人、奉献者们，对你非常仁慈，亲身来看望你。
You should consider this opportunity to be a great mercy for you.
你应该认为这个机会是对你的莫大的祝福。
They're so kind, they're traveling with me. And wherever they go, they immediately make the whole atmosphere pure.
那么这样仁慈，与我一同漫游各地，途经的地方，使整个的氛围都变得纯洁。
Simply by the touch of their lotus feet, everything becomes transcendental.
仅仅凭借他们莲花足的触碰，一切便超然起来。
So people, they are accustomed to go to the temples, and they also visit holy places of pilgrimage.
人们习惯于到庙里，也常常游历朝圣之地。
And after a lot of association with this kind of activities, then they may go on. They may become purified.
长久的与这些活动联谊，他们便逐渐净化。
So the influence of these great sages is so great that just by seeing them, one immediately can become purified.
圣者的影响是这样深远，只要能看见他们，便能完全洁净起来。
Just by going on pilgrimage or worshipping different deities is very purifying.
前往朝圣之地，或者是崇拜神像，是非常有净化力的。
And it's something, we achieve this by the grace of the saintly persons, by their mercy, we are able to do these things.
藉着圣人的仁慈，我们才可以从事这些活动。
A place of pilgrimage becomes a holy place because of the presence of the saintly devotees there.
圣地之所以能成为圣地，是因为有圣人出现。
So when a person is born as a Brahmana, he immediately becomes the best of all human beings.
当一个人出生为婆罗门，他立刻成为人类中的俊杰。
So if such a Brahmana remains satisfied and practices austerities and studies the Vedas, then he can go on and become a Vaishnava.
倘若这位婆罗门在自我当中得到了满足，修习苦行，研读维达经，他便能成为一位 Vaishnava。
So to become a Vaishnava, that is super excellent. That is the goal.
成为 Vaishnava, 这是多么的伟大呀，这目标。
So then Lord Krishna says that my feature of four-handed Narayan is not so pleasing or dear to me as is the form of a Brahmana devotee.
我的四只手臂Narayana的形象还不及一个婆罗门Vaishnava那么使我感到欣喜和亲密。
Brahmana means somebody who knows the Vedic culture. Brahmana is the sign of perfect knowledge.
Brahmana 意味着熟悉伟达经知识的人，它是完美知识的象征。
And Krishna said, I am the manifestation of all the gods.
Krishna 说，而我则是一切神旨的丰满展示。
The less intelligent people don't understand me.
不甚聪明的人无法明白我。
They don't understand the influence of the Brahmana Vaishnava.
他们不明白 Brahmana Vaishnava 的影响。
They are influenced by the three modes of material nature.
他们受到物质自然三形态的影响。
And that's why they criticize me and my pure devotees.
因此他们竟敢批评我和我的纯粹奉献者。
A Brahmana Vaishnava or a devotee means somebody who's on the Brahminical platform.
因为Brahmana Vaishnava或者奉献者意味着，他是处在婆罗门层面的。So
they can realize me within their heart.
他们可以在心中觉悟到我。So
he definitely knows that the whole cosmic manifestation and its different features are all effects of the different energies of Lord Krishna.
他们肯定能认为整个宇宙展示及不同形象是主不同能力的影响。
So in this way, devotee has the clear understanding of the whole material nature.
奉献者对整个物质自然便有一个清晰的概念。
And this way, the devotee sees Lord Krishna only, and he doesn't see anything else.
奉献者，他在每一行动中只看见我，再无其他。
So the Shuradev said, "Oh, Krishna says to Shuradev, my dear Shuradev, you may therefore accept all these great saintly persons and brahmanas and sages. You should accept them as my bona fide representatives."
Krishna 说，亲爱的 Shukadev， 你可以接受这些伟大的圣人 brahmana 和智者为我真正的代表。And
by worshipping them faithfully, you will be worshipping me more diligently.
你忠诚地崇拜他们，便是诚恳地在崇拜我。And
I consider worship of my devotee to be better than direct worship of me.
我认为崇拜我的奉献者比直接崇拜我还要好。If
somebody tries to worship me directly, without worshipping my devotees, I do not accept that worship.
谁若试图直接崇拜我，而不崇拜我的奉献者，我也不会接受。Even
they may worship me with great opulence, I will not accept their worship.
就算他们以巨大的富裕来崇拜我，我也不会接受。So
in this way, both the Brahmana Shrutadev and the king Bahulashva, they were given association with Lord Krishna, and they worshipped Lord Krishna.
就这样, Shukadeva Brahmana 和 Bahulashva 王在和 Krishna 联谊, 崇拜着他。
Yeah, they worship Krishna and they also worshiped his followers, the great sages and the saintly brahmanas. They worshiped them on an equal level of spiritual importance.
他们不仅崇拜 Krishna, 也崇拜其他的圣者与 brahmana, 在灵性上对他们同等看待。
Both the brahmana and the king achieved the supreme goal of going to the spiritual world.
Brahmana 和国王都达到了真达灵性世界的至尊目标。
The devotee doesn't know anything except Krishna, and Krishna is very dear to his devotee.
奉献者除了主 Krishna 外什么也不认识，而奉 Krishna 则非常钟爱他的奉献者。
Lord Krishna stayed at Maitila. He stayed at both places, both at the house of the Brahmana Shrutadev and at the palace of King Bahulashva.
So Krishna 在 Maitila 的期间，同一时期住在 Shrutadev Brahmana 家中和 Bahulashva 王宫殿中。
So he stayed with them for several days and he gave them a lot of his transcendental instructions and then he went back to his capital city, Dwarka.
他和他们住了几天，慷慨地赐予他们超然教导后便返回 Dwarka 城。
All right, so we will stop here now and ask for any questions.
我们今天晚上就讲到这里，接下来有没有问题？有举手的，插入吗
？Hi Krishna， 请尼辛哈玛拉举接受我恭恭敬敬的顶拜。我有一个就是有两个问题。第一个问题就是尼辛哈玛拉吉讲到里面的那个苦行，我想知道这个所谓的苦行是指什么的苦行呢？第二个问题就是Purushottama 月马上就要来了，我就想请尼辛哈玛拉吉给一点我们建议。能够更好的来服务这个普鲁舍塔玛月。Hare Krishna。
行。这个上下文是哪个地方？
就是讲到那个。就是刚才 读到那个诗节，应该是后面部分的了。
Maharaj, you mentioned about the tapasya. So I would like to know more about the tapasya. This is the first question.
So tapasya.Is to be humble. That's the main thing, the main tapasya, to give all respects to others and to not expect any respect for yourself. That is tapasya, that is humility.
苦行就意味着谦卑，就意味着要尊敬其他人。而不指望别人尊敬自己。
Tapasya is destroyed by intoxication. And pride is a big intoxication. When people are proud, It means they're very intoxicated. So when people are proud, they won't do any tapasya.
就服麻醉品、喝酒，就会毁灭苦行。当一个人骄傲、傲慢的时候呢，他就会洋洋自得、陶醉，即使他就不会从事苦行。
So it's a great tapasya to follow four principles, to give up intoxication, gambling, meat eating, and illicit sex. That is a big tapasya. And to help us to do this tapasya, we have to chant the Hare Krishna mantra.
最伟大的、了不起的苦行呢，就是遵守四项规范原则。 不服麻醉品，不吃鱼肉蛋，不赌博，没有非法的性。为了帮助我们能够遵守这四项原则，我们就要念诵 Hare Krishna。
So when we talk about tapasya, that is the kind of tapasya we want to do. Strictly follow four regulative principles. And try to give Krishna consciousness, go out and try to give Krishna consciousness to others, especially by distributing books.
所以我们的苦行就是严格的遵守这四项原则。除此之外，还会外出把Krishna知觉给予别的人，主要是通过派书的方式。
So that is a great tapasya in the Kali Yuga to distribute Prabhupada's books.
在卡里年代，最了不起的一项苦行就是派发Srila Prabhupada的书籍。 第二个问题是，can you elaborate what should we do in the Purushottama month?
Well, Purushottama month is the time for people to, just like they have a sale in a store. You know, in the shop, they're always selling things, but when they have the sale, they will give special prices. So similarly, Purushottama month is to encourage people to do more devotional service.
就好像在商场里有热卖特价的卖商品，同样的，就是在Purushottama月呢，是为了鼓励人们更多的做服务。So
if you're not very fully engaged in Krishna consciousness, Purushottama month is a good time for you to do more Krishna conscious activities.
如果一个人他不是完全的从事Krishna知觉的活动，那Purushottama月对他来说是一个很好的从事更多Krishna知觉活动的月份。And
you get a lot of benefit by doing more chanting, by reading, by associating with devotees, going to temple. Can cash in, you can get a lot of benefit at this time.
一个人可以在这个月当中呢，从念诵、读书、联谊、去庙宇，得到大量的好处。Yuvati Sachi, Madaji.
Hare Krishna, dear Guru Maharaj. Hare Krishna, Guru Mani Mataji. Please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Thank you very much for the wonderful class, Gurudev. My question is, what is the spiritual mind and the spiritual senses? How can we understand these words properly?
You had this such, Mataji,的问题是，我想了解灵性的心意。 以及灵性的感官。
Spiritual mind and spiritual senses are when they're used in the service of Krishna. When your mind and senses are used in the service of Krishna, then they're spiritual.
当心意和感官被用来服务是 Krishna 的时候呢，它就变成了灵性的心意和灵性的感官。
Mind and senses used for material sense gratification are material. But when you use your mind and senses for Krishna's service, then that's spiritual.
倘若心意和感官被用来从事物质的感官享乐的时候，它就是物质的心意和感官。如果用来是服务 Krishna, 它就是灵性的心意和感官。
Okay.
Thank you, Gurudev. Guru Maharaj, I have one more question. If nobody has other questions. My question is about chapter 6 of first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. In verse 15, it is said that Narada Muni meditated on the super soul. And in the next verse, it is said that he meditated on the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord. And how to understand correctly this contradiction?
Well, the super soul also has the lotus feet. Right? So you could be meditating on the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, who is the super soul.
Uh-huh. 伊瓦提萨奇的第二个问题是在第 Bodhavatam 1.6.15 中说 Narada Muni 冥想超灵。在诗节16又说 Narada Muni 冥想主的莲花足，那这两个关系是什么呢？马尔说超灵也有莲花足，所以他是在冥想超至尊主的以超灵形象出现的至尊主。
Yes, right.
So this is the same object of meditation. Yes, Gurudev.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much. Please accept my obeisances.
所以这两个师姐说的是也同以同件事，他们说是的。Yogita Radha Devdasi.
Hi, Krishna Gurudev. Please accept my humble obeisances. Hi, Gurudev. Gurudev, I want to ask. You know, even if we recommend people now to start chanting, take the advantage of chanting in Purushottama Masa in month, they will probably ask, telling them that there's a special benefit. They may ask, what is the special benefit? It's the same as chanting on any other day, right? So they will ask Gurudev, what is the special benefit? What can I tell them?
Well, special benefit is you get more mercy of Krishna. You get more benefit from chanting, it gives you more, the mode of, more, it destroys more sinful reactions than ordinary chanting. You can destroy many more sins.
Okay.
Yogita Radha Madaji 的问题是说，有的人会问，在 Purushottama 月份，据说念诵有特殊的好处，是可以解释一下什么特殊的好处吗？马哈尔说，这特殊的好处就是能更多的得到 Krishna 的仁慈，能得到更多的好处，并且能摧毁更多的罪恶业报。
All right, good. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
那维慧有个问题，尊敬的 Guru Deva， 请接受我卑微的顶拜。我的问题是，作为一位新奉献者，是不是联谊特别重要？比如，是否与灵应导师亲身联谊，对新奉献者特别重要有益 ？So, dear Guru Deva, please accept my humble obeisance. my questions as a new devotee. Is the association especially important for a new devotee? For example, the association physically with spiritual master is especially important for new devotee.
Yes, very important. Not only for new devotees, for other devotees also. We all need association. Even senior devotees, we need association. The Goswamis of Vrindavan were very, very advanced, but they used to associate together to discuss Krishna consciousness.
是的, 不仅是新的奉献者, 别的奉献者也需要联谊, 年长的奉献者也需要。 文达们的六个双米已经非常进步了, 他们仍然会联谊讨论Krishna之觉。
So yes, your spiritual advancement really depends on having association.
所以您的灵性进步就依赖于联谊。
Because you get devotion from the devotees. But if you don't associate with devotees, then how will you get devotion?
因为奉爱来自于奉献者，如果不和奉献者们联谊，那又何来奉爱呢？
So we advise all the devotees to always try to take association, but as much as you can, whenever you can.
我们建议奉献者们会尽可能多的联谊。 She said, she understand Gurudeva.
Okay.
And now, 没有更多的问题了。 And Muki, 妈妈姐, 是不是没有了？ That's all question for tonight, Maharaj.
Okay, so then we'll stop here. Thank you very much, Gurumani Mataji, for Omagansha Gurumani, Giwoman Fani, Omagansha Padma Mukhi Mataji, Jojo, Omagansha Sawada Functionsa, Ling Ting, Omajufu Niman, Wanshat Rui, Chwanjao Shun Li, Wan An, Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Maharaj.